This week on Maker Update, a pie-powered portrait plotter, screaming plants, time for your old TV, trash Kang, big bones, and a quest for animatronic perfection. Hey, I'm Donald Bell, and welcome back to another Maker Update. I hope you're all doing well and excited for Halloween this weekend. If you need some last-minute inspiration, I've got some cool projects to share with you. I've also got lots of non-Halloween stuff too, including the project of the week. As part of their master's thesis, Felix Fisgus and Joris Wegner created this beautiful-looking computer vision portrait plotter. They call it the Pankraz Pictograph, and it uses these vertically mounted jointed arms to move the pen across the paper. Now, I've shown dozens of plotter projects on this show. This one is really something special, and I'm not even sure where to start on how to geek out on it. I guess let's start with how it looks. It looks like a commercial product. It looks better than most Kickstarter projects, but it's not for sale. The whole look is flawless, from the powder-coated sheet metal enclosure, the stand, the aluminum arms, the tiny touches like the braided cables and the remote control. It looks like it should be in a museum. But then there's the software, which we get an incredible description of thanks to a PDF write-up they composed for their master's evaluation. The first software layer is a combination of open frameworks and OpenCV. It's running on a Raspberry Pi 3 with a connected camera mounted up in the top left corner of the panel. This is the real heart of the machine, and it handles a surprisingly involved number of steps to process each image, adjust the contrast, detect edges, vectorize the design, and apply a drawing style. All of this is detailed in the PDF. The other software layer is the code used to drive the stepper motors, which is handled by some trinamic drivers connected to a teensy microcontroller communicating back to the Raspberry Pi. And remember, it's not just doing XY coordinate stuff, it's moving these jointed arms around and triggering the servo to lift the pen on and off the paper. The whole thing is outstanding and definitely has me inspired to create interactive projects at a higher level of fit and finish. I also love that it's a collaboration. As we emerge from this pandemic, I am excited to work with other makers again. More projects. Sam March has a new video out on how he turned his houseplants into screaming babies that cry out for water when their moisture levels are low. To make it happen, he created a custom circuit board design and Arduino code that tracks light and moisture levels and triggers the baby cry alert when things aren't going so well. To take it to the next level, Sam also created a companion app that plots the water and light levels on a cute chart. You can find the code, the CAD files, and the board files all on his GitHub page. On Instructables, marciot has a quick guide on turning an old CRT TV into a retro 80s themed clock that you can configure over Wi-Fi. You'll need an ESP32 compatible board and an RCA cable, and that's about it. With the code uploaded and the cable connected with jumper wires, you can call up the settings menu by connecting to the ESP32 just like you'd connect to a Wi-Fi router. It's a cool trick, though I'm sure the image would burn in over time. What I'm mostly excited about is this idea that you can send composite animations like this out of an ESP32 board using just two wires. Now for some Halloween projects. OCDmaker shows how they made this life-size lawn decoration of Kang the Alien from The Simpsons. Not only do I love how this thing looks, but I can't get over how scrappy and low-tech it is. You're looking at chicken wire, tarps, pool noodles, a hula hoop, and a beach ball for the eye. To make it move back and forth, they attach the eye to an old oscillating fan. It's projects like this that help me realize that I probably have everything I need in my junk pile to make something fun for Halloween, and sometimes it's the improvised look of the thing that makes it endearing. That said, if you're gonna sink the time into something, why not go big? Check out this giant foam skeleton that looks like it's busting out of the house. On Instructables, Haunted Spider shows how he created these giant props using PVC pipe as the armature and foam sheets that he glued and carved by hand. It's a real process, but along the way he offers tons of tips for getting the look you want. One in particular that I thought was useful is this technique for coating the foam with PVA glue and sand to form a bone-like texture. And once you've graduated from Haunted House to Amateur Imagineer, you'll be ready for Kieran Meadows' 10-part series I'm making an animatronic rod puppet. From eye mechanisms to jaws, sketching your character, working out the mechanics in Fusion, cabling, servos, 3D printing, casting, it's an incredible resource, and I don't think many people know about it yet. Go check it out. Now for some tips that are more immediately practical. TechnoChic at BrownDogGadgets offers 6 ideas for taking a cardboard robot costume to the next level. Most of these involve a simple microcontroller action of some kind, theater chase LED animations, a gauge made with a servo, LEDs that react to your voice. There's a lot of great ideas here that you can add to a costume or prop. If you're looking for a spooky way to keep your driver bits organized, this Denture bit holder by iplop may do the trick. It also recently got the 3D Thursday treatment from the Ruiz brothers at Adafruit. Speaking of 3D printing, for this week's Digi-Key Spotlight, they've got a new video out that outlines their 3D printing service. It's all of the convenience of 3D printing and none of the hassles or hardware upkeep. Or maybe you're like me and you have a regular FDM 3D printer, but you want to print a part in SLS without investing in the technology. The Digi-Key service, which is powered by Jabil, gives you a bunch of options and handles all the headaches. And that does it for this week's show. Be sure to subscribe, leave a thumbs up, leave a comment. If you've got a cool Halloween decoration or costume that you came up with this year, I'd love to hear about it. You can get on the Maker Update email list if you want to stay on top of each week's show. A big thanks to Digi-Key Electronics. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you soon.